Okay. Wait, no? I share my screen. So, in last class, I have shown you the STES algorithm, but before that, maybe some of you are confused. Just know a little bit of basics. So, block cipher principle. Block cipher means I have already explained to you guys in block cipher what we do. We just divide our plain text into certain number of blocks. Then we perform the encryption on each block. Then we convert it into same number of ciphertext. So if your input size block is 12 bit or 64 bit, then the generated encrypted message or cipher message will be of same length. That will be either 12, 64, and so on. And the strength of any cipher will depend depend mainly on the key strength. Okay. So your block cipher scheme, there are different schemes. So some of the popular schemes are digital encryption standard, which we are going to discuss, or we have already discussed the main thing. Then we have triple DES. It's also a variant of DES. About triple DES, we will learn later. Then we have more advanced encryption standard. About AES also, this part will come later. Then we have other three types. One is IDEA, one is Two-Fish, and one is Serpent. So in this chapter, we will mainly discuss about DES, triple DES, and AES. Okay, then there will be some other methods, but not the Two-Fish. So instead of Two-Fish, we will discuss this Blowfish one. Because Two-Fish is just based on the Blowfish. Okay. So all these block ciphers are mainly based on your crystal cipher. Again, your crystal cipher is just a name. Crystal cipher is based on a very old theory, and that theory is proposed by Shannon. They gave that idea of SP. That means substitution and permutation network. So Fistel is definitely a person who mainly proposed a process where we just do a block ciphering by taking the product of the cipher, then execute one or more round generation of ciphertext with the help of the key. So the main approach will be like, if your key length is of k bits and a block length of n bits, then it will allow almost like 2 power key possible transformation. So we have already discussed, means if there are n number of keys, then there will be of course 2 power n number of possible transformation. But in some other ideal block ciphers, like we saw that the transformation can be like 2 power permutation of n numbers. So this one will be relatively small. If there are k number of keys available, then possible combinations can be 2 power k. Okay. So this concept, as I already mentioned, it's based on your Shannon's network. Shannon's proposed this substitution and permutation network. Remember, in SDES, we use S-boxes. S-boxes are nothing but your substitution, and P-boxes are nothing but your permutation. So what happens in substitution? It just replaces N bits by another N bits. Okay? And your substitution box mainly comes from the idea of diffusion. Okay? Diffusion means dissipate statistical structure of plain text over a bulk of ciphertext. So, 1 bit change in plain text can change many bits in the ciphertext. Okay. So, this substitution as boxes is mainly based on this diffusion. Okay. if you remember, the S boxes were like from 4-bit, we generated 2 bits and all, like for SDS, for DES, it is a 6 bit, from 6 bit, we convert into 4 bits. So substitution is just we replace N bit by another N bit. Remember, the 4 bit was replaced by 2 bit in case of SDES. And it's mainly based on the diffusion. That means even there is a single change in the plain text, the generated cipher text, there can be lots of other many changes in the bits of cipher text. Okay. Then your permutations are your P boxes. Remember, in SDES we have like a fixed permutation numbers. So permutation is nothing but where all the bits are rearranged and they have some fixed rearrange permutation numbers. So no bits are added and removed. Mostly the bits are just rearranged. And this permutation is mainly based on a confusion. What is confusion? Confusion is just make relationship between ciphertext and key as complex and possible. So main function of this permutation, which is based on confusion, so it just makes our ciphertext or any internal thing more complex so that it's not very easy to decrypt by the third party or using any cryptanalysis. So your DES is just an example of your FISTL cipher process. Okay. So FISTL network mainly depends on like block size, key size, number of rounds, subkey generation, round function, and some analysis, encryption, decryption method. So block size means, remember in DES we use different blocks. So this is the encryption process your FISTL cipher. So what we do, suppose your plain text is of n bits, and of course we will generate the same number of cipher bits. So we will simply divide the plain text into two halves. Then we will use each of this half for different purposes. Okay. Suppose we just first divide into two halves, then perform a substitution on left data half, and based on the function of right half, plus obviously we will use some key and we will perform some round function. Okay, see here we have some number of rounds. So it is, if we increase the number of rounds, obviously it will increase the security, but it will also slow the cipher. And subkey generation is like greater the complexity of analysis will be the harder. Okay. So if there are more rounds, suppose in case of DES, suppose you have two rounds. Remember, in simplified DES, we just do like two rounds of three rounds, XOR of one half with the key. So it's just based on your FISTL cipher. The process is that we just divide the plain text into two halves, then take the right half and do a XORing process with the key one. Then we again combine both halves, and after that we will again do the same process. So every time we will just take one half, then we will XOR with one key, then we will again doing swap, then again do the same process. So this type of process can run for many times. It can be 1, 2, 3, 4 and up, and finally we will get our cipher text. Okay, so we can say the substitution will be in one half. Means left side will be used for substitution, then right half we mainly use to XOR with the key. Then swapping process is nothing but that switching process. I can discuss that simplified DES again, don't worry. So after this permutation, we just do swapping of the two halves and we will just keep repeating this process. Okay. So this whole process will mainly based on this elements. So block size, if we increase the block size, it will improve the security. Again, it will slow the cipher. Then key size, again same, if we increase the key size, it will be it will improve the security, but it will be like very exhaustive and complicated. Okay, and the cipher processing will be slow. Then number of rounds already explained. If you increase the number of rounds, it will be secure, but again slow. Then round function also, depending on the round function, you will means you have to decide what type of round function you want to use. Okay, like in this normal case, the round function is like we will just XOR a subkey. Okay, I have already mentioned the steps. So step one will be input block on each round divided into two halves, left and right. Then in each round, okay, whatever I just explained now is the same process. We will just divide into left and right part, and for each part, we will just perform XOR operation with the help of key. So using key and write, we will simply perform XOR, then we will get an output, then that output will be fused with the left part and so on. So it's just the same process. And for the decryption process, it will be just opposite. It's just reverse process. Whatever you do in encryption, the decryption will be the reverse process. Then for DES is also a block cipher. And DES is just nothing but your direct implementation of your crystal cipher. That's why your simplified DES is also a crystal cipher. Remember, we did like a FK function. That FK function is nothing but your crystal cipher. And where we did that initial permutation, S boxes, P permutation and all. Okay. So in case of normal DES, it takes 16 round crystal structure. Okay, so as I mentioned, there can be different rounds. So for DES, the round will be 16 round, and it takes a block size of 64 bits. Then it will also generate a 64 bit ciphertext, and for that it will use 56 bit key. Okay, then okay, it's just same thing. So this is the main general idea. We will take 64-bit plain text. We will do initial permutation. We'll do lots of rounds. Here there are 16 rounds. And for each round, we will use 1111 key. In simplified DES, I say two rounds. Why? Because we use two keys. So if we increase the number of keys, the round will increase two. So for each round, we will generate a 48 bit key. Okay, then after that, this 48 bit key will be finally permuted into 64 bit ciphertext again. Okay, so DES we are not going to check, that's why I showed you guys the simplified DES portion. So, simplified DES is just the same process, just that everything is a bit simpler. In DES is widely used, and it's really difficult to crack DES. So it's a very famous one. And simplified DES is just for educational purpose, and so that you just understand the whole concept of DES. So you guys remember the steps of SDES? See, in simplified DES, we have only two rounds, and in DES, means normal DES, we have 16 rounds. And in case of SDES, we use 8-bit plaintext, and we generated 8-bit of ciphertext with the help of 10-bit key. Okay, so rest is everything same. Are you guys all clear about this process? Last time I did. Actually, that one was half done. Anyone completed? Oh, I have done until here. I did until here. So this half was still left to do, and I thought you guys would do that. I guess no one tried. So I'll just, you guys want to repeat me? the simplified one. So in simplified one, I'm just repeating again, five main functions. One is initial permutation. Fk is your Fistel block. Just now we said it's just combination of permutation and substitutions, right? P boxes and S boxes. Then swapping is just switching. Again, we will do Fk function. Then again, IP inverse. That means whatever we did in initial permutation, we will just reverse it. And for both encryption and decryption, we use a 10-bit key. So the main permutations involved in key generation. So first step for simplified DES is your key generation. And in SDES, we mainly use two keys. Two keys, that means there are two rounds. Just like I mentioned in Fistel cipher block, there will be different rounds based on the number of keys. So the main permutations involved are P10, P8, and P4. So these are all fixed. So if we just number out any bits, it will be 10 bit, of course. So we will just number our bits into 1 to 10, then generated output will be in this way. Okay. So the main key generation process was, we will just give a 10 bit key. After that, we will divide into two halves. After that, we will do left shift. Then we will put in P8 table. This is our P8 table, right? So after that, we will get one key. Then again, using the right half and do the left shift key, again put it in P8 and do the key 2. Do you guys remember the key generation process?
Yes, ma'am.
Remember, for the key I took, so this was our key, which is a 10 bit. How we did it? What was the step after key? P10. How we did that?
The numbers.
Okay, if we just write it like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, what was the output for P10?
3, 5, 2, 7, 4, 10, 1, 9, 8, 6.
7, 4, 10, 1, 9, 8, 6. So how we did it? We simply substituted. 1 will come here, 5 means 0, 2 means 0, 7 means 0, 4 means 0, 10, 0, 1 is 1, 9 is 1, 8 is 0, and 6 is 0. So this was our output after P10. So after that, what we did? We just split, right? We just divide into two halves, correct? So after dividing, what we did? We did a left shift. Correct, left shift by 1 bit. So after left shifting, what we got? It was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's just circular left shift. Then for this one, 1, 1, 0, 0, and 0. After that, what we did? We again combine. Correct. So for combining, it will be 8. Okay. So what we did after that?
P8.
We put it in P8 table, correct? P8 table, again we can just number it like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. What was the output for P8? Six,
6, 3, 7, 4, 8, 3, 10, 9.
8, 6, 3, 7, 4, 8, 5, 10, 9. So from this 10 bit, we get an 8 bit number, right? So your first and second bit was removed. So we will just replace it. Means generated, this is the expected output, 6. 3, 7, 2 is 0, 8 is 0, 5 is 1, 10, 0, 9, 0. So this was your first key, right? After P8, we get key 1, correct? So what we did again? We used the same thing again here and we splitted it. Right, we split this portion again. Again, we did left shift 2. Right, for left shift 2, what was the answer? There's 1 0. 0 0 0 0 for this 1 1 3 1 1. We just shifted into left shift, circular left shift by 2 bit. Correct? This 11 will come here. So after this, what we did? Again we combine, correct? Now what we did after this? We again put it in P8 table. Again you can just number it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. That's the output, 6, 3, 7, 8, 5, 10, 9. So your main output bit will be 0, 1, and 1. So this was your key 2. So this is your key generation process for SDES, correct? So this
ma'am, how we get this P10 after splitting this 1 1 0 0 0?
P10,
yes ma'am, this split part.
Split, which split? First split is after P10. This
first
is
one, first split.
This one, right? This is the split portion. This is the output after split. That means I just divided into two halves, right? Then after splitting it, I just did left shift by 1. That means what? This will be shifted by 1 bit. So result will be this one. And same thing, we are shifting it by this way. So this one will come 1 bit here. 1 bit here, everything will be shifted to the left by 1 1 1 bit. Is this clear? So this is the output of P10. Okay, so after that you need to split it. So I just did it just in one step. After split, this is, after splitting you will do just left shift by 1. So this one half just 1 bit left shift, and this half is also 1 bit skip. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am. It's clear.
Okay, this is your 10 bit. We just divided into two halves, correct? So after splitting, you just left shift by 1 bit. So this one will come here, correct? So after splitting, we will combine it again. This part will be combined again, then we will put it in P8 table. That means this is a 10 bit. From 10 bit output of P10, we will generate a key of P8, because we just put into the P8 table and 1 2 bits are removed, and this is also fixed. Okay, so this is the output of P8. So after getting the first P8, we get the key 1. That means this is your round 1. Remember, for every round we use 1 1 key. So this process, whole process, permutation process, is round 1. Okay, so next second round, what we will do, we will just repeat the same process. Rounds are nothing but it's just same process, we will keep repeating it, correct? So the output of 8, we will again split into two halves. Now this time we will shift by 2 bits. That means these are just shifted by 2 bits. If you shift by 2 bits, this one will come 1 2 2 bit here, right? And similarly, this one will come this by. So first we did just simple left shift, and in the round 2 we did double left shift. Okay, if you want more rounds, then you can just shift into 3 4 and so on. Okay, in DES there are 16 rounds, so you can just imagine how many shifts there will be, and every time there will be different output. The same process will be repeated, and after this is we, after splitting, we will again combine and again will perform a P8 table. Put it in P8 table and we will get the key 2. This is, you can say, round 2. Okay, so in 2 rounds we are getting 1 1 1 1 key. This is just key generation. We just got the key. Now you have to convert plain text into encryption, plain text into ciphertext, correct? So for encryption, what we did? This is your key generation process. The whole block diagram just shows you the key generation process. These are already written, I guess already shared. So for encryption process, what we do? We just give 8-bit plain text. We will perform initial permutation. Then we will just divide into two halves and we'll use the right side, correct? That right side will again put it in a EP table. EP means expand and permute table. I have already written here, initial, after initial permutation, we have already fixed bit output. So this will be divided into two halves. So from 8-bit, we will get 4-bit, 4-bit, left and right half. Then right half will be put into expand and permute table, EP table. So from this 4-bit of right half, we will generate an 8-bit number. Okay, then we will XOR that 8-bit number with the 8-bit key 1, first key we use. After that, we will again divide into two halves and put every half into S boxes. Remember, it's a combination of SP network based on Shannon's principle. So again, from S box 0 and S box 1, we will get 2 2-bits. Again, we will combine it. We will get 4-bit. Then again, we'll put in P4 table. After that, we will just XOR with the left-hand side. Okay, then we will get the result. Then we again divide. Then we will swap, and this process will same. So again, I can say for key 1, this is your round 1, and this is your round 2. See, in normal DES, normal DES for every key. We do 1111 round. Okay. There are 16 rounds, and for DES we have 2 rounds. Simplified DES. So all the steps are written here. You need a break. You should take a break. So remember, after 4 bit we will get 4 bit 1, then we will give into the means doing XOR with the key 1, then again put means divide in 2 halves and give it to the S boxes. These are your definite S boxes. The values are already fixed. Okay, and these S boxes we just write the binary representation of these numbers. Okay, 1 means 0, 1, 0 means 0, 0, 3 means 1, 1, and so on. And we just give the numbers. Okay. You guys remember what was the plain text? So our plain text was 8 bit, correct? After that, what we did, we just put in IP8 table. What was the answer of IP8? Expected output was 2, 6, 3, 1, 4, 8, 5, and 7. So if you replace 2 means 1, 6 means 0, 3 means 1, 1 means 0, 4 means 1, 8 0, 5 0, and 7 is 1. So this is the output of your IP8. So after that, what the process? We will split it. Okay, split means we will simply split it like this. So 1010 and 1001. This left half we will use later. Okay. And now we will only process this right half. Okay. So this is again the Feistel process. What we did, left half we use later, and right half we just do all the different types of processes, round processes. So this right half will go to EP table, right? So if you just use this right half, 1001, just number it, 2, 3, 4, you can even write there. There is nothing there, but anyways, you will just put it in EP table, expand and permute table, and the output was this one, 412, 823, and 41. So 4 means 1, 1 means 1, 2, 3, 0, 2, 3, 0, 4, 1 is 1, 1. This is your output of EP table. Right? So after that, what we do? It's a long process, right? So this EP will be XORed with your first key. Now you will just do this XOR with key 1. What was our key? Key 1 was, this is our key 1, 10, 100, and 100. Means 10, 100, and 100. 10, 100, and 100. If we do XOR, what will be the result? All the dissimilar bit will create
zero,
one, right? 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, right? So next step what? We will again split it into two halves. So if I split it, this answer into two halves, this will go to S0 box and this will go to S1 box, right? So now again for S boxes, we will just fit to S boxes each half. And what was the condition? In S boxes, what we do? Bit 1 and bit 4 will be used to specify rows, and bit 2 and bit 3 specifies your columns. Okay. So first we are going to use this S0, right? For S0, what is our input for S0? S0 input is this one, right? 0 1 1 0. That means this 2-bit will tell you your, so row will be given by first bit and fourth bit, that is 0 0, and column value will be given by your 2 3 1 1. Okay, so what is the decimal representation of 0 0? It's 0, and this is 1. Right, that means what? This is 3. 1 1 means 3. So that means what? In S box, we have to check 0 row and column number 3. Okay, so if this is your S box, what is the number 0 row? 0 means this. This is your 0 row, and column 3 means this. 1 0. Right? So the output of S box will be your 1 0. So this is the output of S0 boxes. Correct? Now for S1, what is the value? 0 1 1 1. Again, this is for row 0 1, and column is 1 1. Decimal value is 1, and this is 3. So that means what? For S1 boxes, you have to check first column and third, first row and third column. For S1 box, we will check first row and third column, which is 1, 1. Right? So your output will be 1. 1. So after this we get output of 1 1. So after this what we do? We will again combine this value of S0 and S1. Okay, so value will be combined. Our combined value is what? Output 1 0 1 1. This is our output. Okay, so now what we will do, we will put it in P4 table. Right, we will put in P4 table. Again, you can just number it 1 2 3 4, and output, what is the output for P4 table? It's 2 4 3 1. 2, 4, 3, 1. So your answer will be 1, 1, and 1. Right? So this is the output of the P4 table. Then you will again XOR with the left half. Okay? XOR with left half. So what is your left half? This is the left half which I said we'll use later. So 1010 is your half. 1010, we will just XOR it with left half 1010. Okay, XOR. So after XORing, what will be the answer? 1101. Okay. Now the final output will be this 1101 plus your right half. Okay. Right half of your IP. What is the right half we use? It is 1001. That means we will combine it with just 1001. So your output will be 1101 and 1001. This is your combined output. And after that, we have to swap both halves, or you can switch. Switch means this part will go this side and this side will go this side. The answer will be 1001 and 1101. Okay, now it's your homework. Okay, what you need to do from this swapping, we will again do that FK2 process. Okay, you guys try at home. You have to do the same process again. That means you are going to divide this combined answer into two halves, and after that again we'll start the whole process from the EP table. Okay, from the EP table. Okay, again we'll start from EP table and do all these things. Just follow this thing, and whatever you get answer, means you have to put it again as boxes and P4 and all, you have to do the IP inverse. Okay, so you have to tell me the answer after IP inverse. Okay, so this whole process will be continued from the EP table. Okay, so this is your homework. You have to tell me the answer. What will be the ciphertext? So this whole process will repeat again in the end. Means you will just split it again, take the right half, put it in EP table, then on. And after that, you have to, whatever answer you get, you have to put it IP inverse, and that will be your ciphertext. So you guys have to tell me the ciphertext, final ciphertext. Okay, that is tomorrow. So that's it. I'll stop sharing and take your attendance. Anyway, everyone is present, I guess. So I have already shared the slides with you guys. So just follow it and see. I guess you guys have done this up till now, so you have to tell me the final answer. Okay, this is your homework. You have to tell me tomorrow. Is that clear to everyone?
Yes,
you have
ma'am.
To do everything again in this hub. Then finally, IP inverse. IP inverse is nothing but your initial permutation table. You have to do it inversely. Okay, if the values were, you have to combine it like this, then inverse will be just the inverse process. Okay, you guys do it first, then I'll tell you the correct answer. So this is a homework. Okay, I'll stop sharing and thank you. I hope it's clear to you guys now, and tell me the answer tomorrow. Thank you.
Yeah, ma'am.